Hi guys, this is a cup of hot tea and I have a tea bag. I put the tea bag slowly in this cup and look what's happening. Well, what you see that the components of the tea bag has diffused into the liquid and the tea becomes a little bit dark. Well, if you have a cup and you put a tea bag, you see that in all the directions this has colored. Normally you are not doing this and you are in a hurry and you do just a few times this and afterwards you drink your tea. Have you ever wondered why diffusion is so important? It's very important because it is the basis of life. Every day you are breathing air into your lungs and oxygen is transferred via our lungs into our blood. And carbon dioxide is going back into the lung through diffusion. And it's even more important because even in the smallest human cell, all kinds of chemicals diffuse through the cell wall, react and move out again. Each day, each moment of the day. That's very important. Diffusion is everywhere and certainly in your body. Today we try to understand the basis of diffusion. Many years ago, Fick already found that the mass flow rate, phi m, by diffusion is proportional to the diffusion coefficient d, multiplied by the surface area and the concentration gradient. The question is, what can we do with Fick's observations? Let's look a little bit better to it. Let's consider this layer of tea leaves in a cup. So tea diffuses in this direction. The question here is, what's the concentration gradient? You can imagine that you can find the highest concentrations near the tea leaf and the lowest somewhere near the interface. The mass will move from x is zero to x is delta. So in fact your mass flow is constant because there is a conservation of mass here. Then there are two more things. First of all, the driving force, because why is the material transferred? Because the concentration C1 here is higher than C2. So delta C is the driving force here. Then there is one property about which we haven't said anything, and this is what we call the diffusion coefficient D. Well, what's the diffusion coefficient? Well, you could see it as follows. The diffusion of a gas in a gas is quite fast because there is space enough between the molecules. But if you have diffusion of air in water, there's less space, so the value becomes lower. And if we have a species in a solid, it becomes much lower. Let's look a little bit at the values. Gases in gases is around 10⁻⁶ meters squared per second. And if you have gases in liquids, it would be 10⁻⁹ meters squared per second. And if you have the same gas in a solid, you would have 10⁻½ meters squared per second. So in steps of 1000, it goes down. Sometimes it goes down so much with, for instance, the solids that move in solids. There you have values of 10⁻²⁰ meters squared per second. Let's go to the leaves because we have a certain material diffusing in the water. And let's derive the concentration profile with Fick's law. Fick's law says phi m is the diffusion coefficient multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the concentration gradient. The question now is, what's the concentration gradient and what's the concentration at each point in the layer between C1 and C2? We can derive this by saying that the concentration min dc dx equal is to phi m divided by the diffusion coefficient A multiplied by the distance dx. And if we integrate this from the interface of the tea leaf C1 till a certain place Cx between the interface and the tea leaf, and we do a similar at the other side, x is 0 and x is x. We can derive the concentration profile now by saying C1 minus Cx is equal to phi m divided by the diffusion coefficient and the surface area multiplied by x. Now we see that we have here a linear concentration profile in the layer between C1 and C2. We could now compare Fick's law, which we now have derived, which is the diffusion coefficient multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the concentration difference divided by the distance, which is Fick, with Fourier's law, which says that the heat flow phi q is equal to the heat conductivity multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the temperature difference over a certain length, which is Fourier. In analogy, you can see between these two equations, the diffusion coefficient and the conductivity are properties of the material. The surface area, that depends where the conduction or diffusion is going around. Delta C is the driving force in the case of mass transfer, and delta T is the driving force in case of heat transfer. So you see there's a large analogy between these two, and even in mathematically, they are quite similar. It would be nice if you would go to the do-it-yourself, which asks you to look in your house to find examples of Fick and Fourier. In your house, you can find a lot of things with Fourier, because a lot of things conduct. Think about burning your fingers. So now every time you burn your hands, you think Fourier. And Fick's law is sometimes more difficult. You can play around and put some concentrated juice or lemon in water and wait until it diffuses. But perhaps you can look in your fridge, because have you ever wondered why your fruit turns dark? Well, the reason is that oxygen diffuses into your fruit, reacts with components in the fruit, and then become bad. Another example is meat packed in a plastic foil. If the foil is very thin, oxygen diffuses through the foil and affects the quality of your meat. That's often the reason that fruit and meat have an expiration date. Think about these things and show us all the phenomena around your house. It's all around you, and we look forward to seeing your response.